Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. If you are a part of Generation Z, you've probably heard of the Kick Messenger. If you are not, let's just say that Kick is a bit like WhatsApp. It aims to be much more though. As a Western copy of Chinese WeChat, it is more of an ecosystem that the user rarely has to leave. It can be used for banking, transportation, shopping, IoT, messaging, and a lot more. In today's episode of Blockchain Central, we will take a look at the Kick ecosystem and analyze their native cryptocurrency called KIN. Let's go. The ICO of KIN went live on September 12, 2017. Within 2 weeks, $98 million was raised by fans and supporters, but unfortunately, the target of $125 million was not reached. From a technical point of view, KIN is also quite interesting. First, the Kick team considered building their token on Ethereum, but this turned out to be too expensive for microtransactions. Then, after briefly considering Stellar, they decided to copy the Stellar code and adapt it to their needs. Today, KIN is still not integrated into the Kick user experience, and as such, it does not yet have a real use case. That is why it is still regarded as a speculative currency, but this will probably change soon. After it is merged with the messenger, the following use cases can emerge. VIP groups. Chat groups will be open to users that are paying. This can be interesting for celebrities and content creators. It would mark the beginning of a new way to engage with fans. Premium content. Things shared in the group could be accessible upon payment. KIN will allow anyone in Kick to ask for money before accessing selected content. Sending money. Sending money on Kick will be as easy as sending a text message. This can be done in groups or one-on-one. The idea is to compensate friends for the pizza last night or settle your poker debt. Bot monetization. KIN will allow bot developers to use money in-app easily. So, if you use a bot to order a pizza, you can pay with one click without worrying about different payment methods. Brand missions. Brands can incentivize people with KIN to do a certain task. One could, for example, post a selfie with a t-shirt of a certain brand. That way, a company can drive its micro-influencers' efforts. In general, the KIN token will allow people to pay for products and services on Kick. This move will bring a lot of additional features to Kick. KIN, however, will not just be for an in-app usage. The plan is to also use the currency outside the main app, for example, to monetize other apps. Currently, the most popular way to monetize an app is through advertisements. But, as we all know, ads are bad for the user experience. KIN could be used for micropayments between the users and the developer to promote a clean and affordable user experience. When monetizing apps, an algorithm decides who gets the newly created KINs. The amount depends on how engaged users are, with the rewards being calculated and distributed daily. A total of 60% of all KIN tokens will be distributed through this reward scheme. It all sounds very promising, but we need to remember that the future of KIN is still very uncertain. It still hasn't been integrated into Kick, and even though the team is transparent about their progress, it could be a reason for concern. So, what have we learned today? KIN is an interesting cryptocurrency. Its goal is to use it for payments on the Kick Messenger. Implementation is in progress, but still not complete. We'll just have to wait and see. Before you go, please note that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing.